What's up, everybody? This is Jerome from the Barbarian Philosopher Podcast, answering the question, does size matter in a fight? To stay up to date with more content on MMA, personal development, and current events, please make sure to hit the subscribe button. A very common adage in the martial arts world is that size doesn't matter. Technique trumps size. In the streets, we hear the saying, it doesn't matter the size of the dog in the fight, but rather the size of the fight in the dog. And while statements like this do have a grain of truth to them, they are vast oversimplifications. It is both naive and irresponsible to set the expectation that size carries no weight, no pun intended. 100% size does matter in a fight. It is not the sole deciding factor, but it does influence the way things go. If you have two people who are all things across the board are equal, same amount of strength, same amount of speed, same numbers of years in training, same technical capacity, same level of toughness, everything else is the same, but one of them has a 20, 30, 40, 50 pound weight advantage, the vast majority of the time, the heavier, bigger person is going to win. The person with more weight, with more reach, with any type of size advantage, does tend to win that fight. It's not something that can't be worked around. It's not something that is written in stone. If the person is bigger, then they will win. But it most certainly leans things in their favor. A fight is all about tilting things in your favor, right? As much as possible, leaning the odds to benefit you. If you're faster than your opponent to a certain percent, you have the advantage. If you're stronger than your opponent to a certain percent, you have the advantage. If you are more experienced, you have a higher pain tolerance, you're more flexible, more creative, less predictable, whatever the attributes may be, the more of them that you have, the more favor that you have. It's silly to pretend as if size is not one of these things. I think where this comes from is coaches and instructors trying to eliminate as much as possible any unnecessary limiting beliefs that the student may hold that might be holding them back and preventing them from bringing the level of self-belief or the level of commitment to what they're doing to actually be effective in a situation wherein the odds do not necessarily favor them, right? When you are a smaller person, whether it be in height or in weight, it is very easy to be discouraged by the obstacle that is the larger person. And it's very easy to focus on how difficult that obstacle may be instead of focusing on how to negate that obstacle. And I think the size doesn't matter slogan is how many professors try to move around that. Another problem that I have with a smaller guy versus the bigger guy argument is that there is a stereotype of the bigger guy being slower, less agile, easier to gas out than the smaller guy. And while as a generality, as a broad generalization, this is true, I think it is overemphasized. There are plenty of big dudes who move like smaller guys. There are plenty of fast, athletic guys who are rather muscular or bulky, who move in a way that you wouldn't think that they could. There are plenty of heavy-set dudes who carry a little extra weight, but they have a cardio regimen. They run, they do whatever it is that they do to maintain their ability to go. And they can go for quite some time. Betting all of your success, putting all your eggs in the basket of this guy's bigger, therefore he'll gas out in 30 seconds, is a dangerous game to play. As much as you can, strengthen all of your attributes, cover as many bases as you can, and don't underestimate anybody. Don't underestimate them because they're smaller and weaker. Don't underestimate them because they're bigger and maybe stronger. Certainly, size and strength are advantages, and as much of them as you can acquire without passing the point of diminishing returns leans things in your favor. Go to the comment section, let us know what you think. What do you believe to be the most important attribute or benefit in a fight? Is it size, skill, speed, durability, endurance to pain? Let us know. I hope you enjoyed this. Hit the subscribe button. Peace.